WorkCenters are powerful features of the PeopleSoft user experience that make using PeopleSoft much more efficient and engaging for users. The framework for building WorkCenters is part of PeopleTools, which means customers have the ability to modify delivered instances or create their own WorkCenters to support their unique enterprise requirements. Creating WorkCenters is a straightforward process that doesn't require coding or using Application Designer. In most cases, subject matter experts can create them in just a few minutes. In this video, we'll focus on creating WorkCenters using the Applications framework. WorkCenters are delivered for applications with four common framework pagelets defined, but not populated, enabling you to customize them to fit your specific needs. There are two ways to configure a WorkCenter. If you want to start with our sample configuration, use the Data Migration Workbench to copy the configuration from the demo system to your database. Or, configure each pagelet using the Common Applications Framework Configure Pagelets component, which is the focus of this video. In this example, we'll modify the Billing WorkCenter configuration using the Common Application Framework. Select the Billing WorkCenter configuration. Whether you're starting with a delivered WorkCenter with unpopulated pagelets or a WorkCenter that already has links configured, the process will be the same. On the Links tab, set the personalization options to enable users to change display options, add their own grouping of links, or keep the page static. Use the Link Group section of the pagelet to add a new link group. Name your group and designate its order on the page. Use the Define hyperlink to define the new link as either a menu item link or a URL. Select any content reference from the menu tree. We'll select the Accounts Receivable link, Customer Accounts, to add to the pagelet. Enter the Display Order, Show Link checkbox, Starting Page checkbox, and indicate whether this link will always open in a new window. Remember, the menu item links obey menu security, so users will only see links to which they have access. Next, add an external URL link to the group by entering the URL and link label. Because there is no menu security for external URLs, set the security access here. Use the public checkbox if everyone who has access to this WorkCenter should see this link. If the link is not public, set the security by entering the permission list, roles, or user IDs of those who will have access to this URL link in any number and combination. Enter the display order and other link attributes. Select the Activate Links Settings button when you're ready for your users to see the links. If your users have previously personalized this pagelet, only new or deleted links will be updated. If the user has changed the display options, these will not be overridden. You'll configure the Reports and Processes pagelet in the same way, with an option to add a default run control if you have permissions to personalize the page. On the Queries pagelet, set the personalization options. If your users need to add private queries, they must have permission to add their own links. Add query or pivot grid links using the prompt table. Use the Access link to set the security. If you have access to Query Manager, you'll see a link on the Queries pagelet. Now we'll configure the My Work pagelet, where you can import system-defined links. Once again, set the personalization option. On the My Work pagelet, the users are only able to set display options. All links are added to the pagelet by the administrator. Next, we'll define the links for the pagelet. There are four types of links that can be defined for the My Work pagelet. System-defined links, which are links that can be filtered to present each user with personalized work. User-defined links, where you build your own application classes and links that you can link to the My Work pagelet. Worklist links, where you can link to a worklist. And alerts, where you can link to the notifications dashboard. Let's focus on adding a system-defined link. Launch the Define My Work link window to get started. The Import Link function offers you more than 150 links to choose from, but we'll limit our search to billing links for this video by selecting Billing in the Object Owner ID field. Select the Invoices Entered Today link. Use the Details column for explanations for each link. You can set up the filter definition now or do it later in the Configure Filter Definition component. The prompt shows all the filters that are valid for this link. Each system-defined link has a filter definition that is supplied as system data, delivered in PeopleSoft Update Image 5. You can select one of these filters or add a new filter. If you select an existing filter, you can modify it in the Configure Filter Definitions component. We'll select the BI filter and activate this link. To modify the BI filter fields, we'll go to Configure Filter Definitions and review the fields that were set up for this filter. You'll see more options for fields to display by clicking the prompt. In many cases, the business unit has a security view. If you use one, enter it in the prompt table field. Whenever we use a security view, we need to make the filter value required and restrict the operands or checkboxes. This means you can't leave the prompt value blank and retrieve all rows. Restricting operands means that only equal or in list values are supported. You can also choose to exclude the in list if your users only use a single business unit. If you do include the in list, you will fill in the in select properties. On the in select properties tab, select the search field and search field description that will be used when you want to select by the in operand. For example, we want to select by business unit value and show the business unit description. The public checkbox determines whether users can set their own filter values for this filter. If the box is not checked, you can authorize certain users by user ID, permission list, or role to control their filter values. If a user cannot edit filter values, then these must be set by an administrator using the Configure Filter Values component or the Filter Value Copy Wizard that was introduced in PeopleSoft Update Image 4. If you've made your filters public, then users will set their filter values the first time they try to use a system-defined link. Continue to personalize the WorkCenter using the methods provided to build a complete WorkCenter. Use the PeopleSoft WorkCenter application framework to create or modify delivered WorkCenters, personalizing your pagelets and links to build a WorkCenter that fits your unique business requirements. For more information about using the PeopleTools framework to modify WorkCenters, see Configuring WorkCenters PeopleTools Framework.